So this year's CES seems to show that the future from WALL-E looks like it's just around the corner. If tech companies are right, then in a few years, we're all gonna be talking to our fridges and having servant robots wait on us hand and foot, and we're never gonna talk to another human ever again. Welcome back to What's Trending, I'm Grant Pardee. So we're in a place where technology has made our lives so easy that I think the tech companies don't really know what to do next. The only way for technology to innovate further is to just live our lives for us. That's right, I'm not only predicting that the robot takeover is at hand, I'm saying that it's already happened. In fact, I myself am an advanced AI robot sent from the future back in time to host YouTube videos. That's how pointless tech has become. Yeah, bro, Siri, Alexa, they're my great-grandparents. And this balancing robot, that's my papa. I feel like you can see the resemblance in the face. You know how pizza delivery is a total pain in the ass? Well, it isn't, but Pizza Hut and Toyota are nevertheless teaming up to eliminate the hassle of exchanging 2 to 3 sentences with your delivery driver by unveiling their state-of-the-art driverless delivery vehicle. I mean, credit to Pizza Hut for looking at their company and saying, all right, we need to improve something. Should we make our food less garbage? Or should we take the soul out of delivery? If this sounds a little bit like an episode of Black Mirror to you, you're not alone. The Netflix tech horror show retweeted Pizza Hut's announcement with the caption, "We know how this goes." Finding the right balance between helpful and completely unnecessary seems to be the theme at this year's CES. For example, Foldymate is a $1,000 robot that can kind of fold your laundry for you. And I say kind of because by most reports, it doesn't work for pretty much anything except like towels. And like for me, as someone that does spend money on stupid shit, I don't like laundry. Like it's my least favorite chore, but the most fun part of laundry is the folding part. Like low key matching the little socks together is fun. I don't mind it, it's okay. Meanwhile, Samsung and LG are both really leaning into their smart refrigerators, adding more AI and voice controls to the products. So I feel like we're getting a glimpse into like the inner lives of the engineers that are developing these products, you know? Like I imagine it's like a rainy, lonely Friday night, and the engineer's like, I guess I'll order a pizza, but then I'll have to see another human person. I wish I could just talk to you, fridge. You're my only friend, refrigerator. What Samsung wants is for your fridge to act as the centralized hub for all of your smart devices. So you'd be able to use voice commands to, say, dim the lights in another room without the hassle of touching the light switch. The built-in tablet can also play music, share calendars, show photos, and do other tablet-y things, but now on a fridge. I feel like maybe I'm coming across like a cranky old man here. Like back in my day, we wrote sticky notes and we put it on the fridge. Sometimes they were helpful, most of the times they were passive aggressive, but we liked it, we liked to do it, and we all had fun doing it. Is that how old people talk? I don't think it is. LG's smart fridge showed how its AI software could communicate with your smart oven and other smart appliances. So if you wanted to have chicken for dinner, it could conjure up some recipes and then preheat the oven. Or if you have a gym workout on your calendar, then it would know to prepare the washing machine. The idea is that these devices would eventually learn your habits and anticipate your needs, like a stalker that you bought from Amazon. In other words, what they're doing is they're kind of expanding on the thing from previous models of smart fridges where they would know when you're low on a certain item and then automatically order those groceries for you. But hold up a second, let's go back to that previous image. Yeah, enhance, enhance. Who is this motherfucker? Was he here the whole time? Yeah, man, it's companion robots. They're here, or close to here. This is Chloe, a small robot that companies like LG hope will become an integral part of your home routine. The only problem right now is they don't work. During the tech demonstration, Chloe was almost entirely uncooperative. LG speaker David Vanderwall repeatedly attempted to show off Chloe's voice recognition, but the robot turned him down and ignored him every time. It's like the robot was like, nah man, I'm not gonna do your laundry, you do your laundry. I'm a robot, I'm gonna sit here and make googly love eyes with that toaster over there. Don't use any of those, Mitch, those were bad.
I left him in.
And LG sees these robots becoming your sidekicks outside the home too. They believe the company's future is in the development of their artificial intelligence and claim to have successfully tested robots that can wheel food to humans, carry luggage at the airport, and even go with them to the grocery store to help select products they've already chosen on an app. Which kind of seems like we could cut out the middleman on that one, right? Like, why doesn't the robot team up with the Pizza Hut driver so I don't have to go to the grocery store at all? LG said their long-term plan is for these robots to develop the capacity for emotional interaction, which once again, just seems to be like a cry for help from the developers. Dudes, if you need a friend, just, I don't know, reach out, man. Like, we can chat, I guess. I don't know. I don't feel like you need to be creating the Terminator future just because no one wants to hang out with you. Eolus was another robot on display at CES, which is more along the lines of the robot made from the Jetsons. Eolus has gripper arms that can be adjusted for different tasks, like bringing you a beverage or picking up clothes off the floor. Eventually, the Eolus developers imagine the robot able to operate the microwave and the dishwasher, which, if you've ever wanted to see a robot get electrocuted, just wait for Eolus, I guess. The goal is to have the first version of Eolus available for purchase before the end of 2018, likely retailing for several thousand dollars. Now, there is no mention of whether or not you can have sex with these robots, but they're all thinking it. You know they are. We have sex robots. Now we've got these robots. I'm telling you, we're 1 or 2 years away from CES being like, all right, guys, we figured it out. This is a robot that's a fridge, that knows what you want. It's also your best friend. It can bring pizzas to you without you ever having to look another person in the eye. And the best part, you can f*** it. But I don't know, I'm dumb as hell. We wanna know what you guys think. Let us know in the comments below. Do you think this is a good development? Are we seeing the kind of technology that we need? Or are these companies overvaluing AI, robots, smart home integration, and they're just trying to do buzzy things that'll make dopes like me make videos for them? Let us know, comment below, and for more stories, go to whatstrending.com.